Hey guys, what's up? So glad that you're here today. Just a reminder, like, comment, subscribe if you like this video, even if you don't, but I know you will because I have the craziest story to tell you guys. It's just like, I don't know if I should share this type of content, but I thought to myself, no, yes, no, yes, no, yes, yes, I have to because you guys have to hear how crazy this was. Like, I'm honestly a different person now than I was before this. Like, this was last Friday. Thursday, I was one Julia. Like, Friday night, 11:49 p.m. I'm a different person. Like, absolutely different. Like, I'm not even sure that my friends will recognize me. I don't know if you guys will recognize me, but like, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. You can just like, click on the link. You know how it goes. And yeah, so I'm just gonna like, get right to it. So, it was a Friday night. Okay, so like the girls are coming over, and so I did a little face mask, you know, just wanted to look like amazing going out because it's, you know, one of the last Fridays of the year. I had to just rock it. So I called my girlfriends and like, come on over, and they're like, are we gonna eat now or eat later? So we had like a little bit of a snack, and we had like some hummus and veggies. Like, I went to Trader Joe's first. And I just picked up some veggies and some hummus, and like, I mean, I can eat dairy, but like, I know that my friends can, so I got them like a bit of like a yogurt ranch dip as well for the vegetables and some chips, and like, I can't eat gluten, but like, I got some chips for my friends, you know, who might want that. So they like came over eventually. Like, some people like took lifts there, some people drove, and like, the parking on my street is so bizarre, so that was kind of tough. Like, we definitely had to take a little bit of time to do that, but they came over, and like, we went up to my room, and we're like, oh my god, like, what kind of night is this gonna be? Like, are we like wearing jeans and like drinking whiskey gingers, or are we like having margaritas and like going crazy? Are we like sipping red wine and like gonna giggle about it? Like, what kind of night were we having? It took us a little bit of time to decide because, like, I mean, that's an important thing. Like, it's Friday night, like, how are we gonna spend it, you know? So we are all just hanging out, like eating the veggies and the hummus, like just kind of catching up. Cause you know, like, everyone has come from a different place that day, like in their day. So they have to, like, the whole week, and it's Friday. It's like the time to be like, this happened to me this week. This is how I'm different this week. Like, this is the amazing thing happened. And of course, like, all of them had amazing things to share because my friends are just so inspiring. Like, having them around is just, I mean, I was laying in bed like, oh my God, I don't even know if I am hungry or if I'm not hungry. Like, I had no idea. And then my friends come over and suddenly it's just like, it's gonna be good. So like, one of my friends, she's like really, really artsy. So she brought over this sculpture that she'd been working on all week. And I was like, oh my God, it was so amazing. It was really beautiful. And she just like told us every detail about how she did it. Like, it's crazy what this girl can do. Just like, such an artist. Anyway, back to the story. Okay, so now like, we've got the idea of where the night's gonna go, and we just like decide we're gonna start drinking. So one of my friends just brought over this bottle of tequila that she'd had. She'd actually won it at this like crazy event she had at her work. But anyway, that's important for the story later. So we start doing shots. Crazy. Like, apparently it was gonna be a shots night. And so we just like lined up the glasses and like poured it perfectly. Like, the chasers are lined up. We've got like a couple of different options, like the cranberry juice or like the soda or like the Diet Coke for that one girl. So that's important later on. So we start drinking. It's like crazy already. Like, we're just like hit like crazy. The music is just pumping us up. We're like, know exactly what the outfits are gonna be. And I'm like, should I wear this choker? And like, the choker is definitely like, oh, we're gonna have like a little bit of fun tonight kind of choker. But I didn't know if it was just like too much with my outfit. But I guess like, you needed to see my shoes, which, come back. So my shoes, like, that's important actually to know for the story. Like, they were just these like really special shoes. Just, you need to know that much. But anyway, so we like start drinking. We're like, okay, like, this, we should probably go before we like get too drunk, you know? So we like call our Uber, and this guy, like, his name is like Fernando. He comes to pick us up, and he's just telling us all about his day. And like, of course, he works in the music industry, so he's just like showing us his single. And we're like, actually, this is like really great, and it was really awesome along with our night. And so then he like, he was just like, oh, you guys should, he told us this cocktail that we should try at this one club. And we're like, okay, like, take us to that club. So we arrive at the club, and like, I texted Matt, and he was gonna meet us there, which is super exciting. But he was just like telling me that he had this like bear come to his work. It was so crazy. Anyway, that is not important to the story. So for those of you who don't know, like Matt is my like sort of, kind of, not yet, like not really boyfriend, but like he's really awesome. But if you don't know who Matt is, just like pause this video right now, go find out under my story time. It's just like all about Matt. You need to know all about Matt in order to like really get the full feeling of this night, you know? And then like the craziest thing that's ever happened to me, actually ever. So we are at the club, and actually, there was this like traffic light that was down, so it took us a little bit of time to actually like get to the club, but Fernando was really awesome about it, and he was just like, guys, I'll get you there, don't you worry. So we arrive, we walk in, we're like looking really sexy, like feeling really good, you know, we're just like the perfect amount of buzz. So then we go to the bar, and we're like, we order the cocktail that he like told us to order, and the bartender was just like not wanting to serve us because there's this one girl in our group who's just like a little too drunk, but it was weird because she drank as much as we did. She's just like can't handle it as well, you know? Maybe she didn't have enough like veggies and hummus, whatever. But anyway, so we get another drink, and we're just like feeling it. We're dancing, we're having so much fun. And then we like decide that to all go to the bathroom and just like do a little touch up on our makeup. And I'm like, I actually just felt really the need to like change my lip color. Like I had a little bit of a purple going on. I was just like, no, this is more like a nude kind of night. Like just like a subtle lip, you know? We're just like feeling a little more subtle once we got there. It's just like, oh, we didn't have to try so hard because like we're so hot, you know? So then we are at the club, and like I'm still texting Matt, like he's supposed to be coming. Super excited to see him at this point. So we get there, we're like having so much fun, and then just like one of my friends is just like, she's just like a little too drunk. So she like starts throwing up like on the dance floor, and like one of the bouncers was like, you guys like need to get it together. So like that, you know, it's like kind of puts a little bit of a damper on the night, but like that's important later on to like the thing that literally changed my life. Like I'm actually a different person. By the time the story is over, like you guys have no idea. Like this is actually really, really hard for me to share. And I know that like I've been really normal about it, but like you guys are just gonna see like completely into my heart in the next couple minutes. And just like what I went through. I hope a lot of you guys can connect to it. Like that's why I felt the need to share, you know? So like, as I said, like my friend, she was feeling sick and she threw up on the dance floor. But the really important thing to note in that is that this is the only friend that did not have the cocktail. The one that like Fernando, the Uber driver, like recommended to us. Like she's the only one who did not have the fake news cocktail. That's what it was called, the fake news. It was just like a little bit of mezcal, a little bit of Aperol, and like orange juice and a couple other things. I don't really remember, but I mean, it tasted really good. It actually was like a really tasty cocktail. It was like a bright orange drink, a bright orange cocktail. It was just bright orange, and had like a little bit of like a flower garnish in it. I'm not really sure what the kind of flower is, but it was edible. It kind of like, it was like the orange cocktail. It just kind of reminded me of like the president if he were gay. Yeah. So my friend's really sick, whatever. We're like trying to get out of the club. So we just like call another Uber. We're just gonna like figure out where the night's gonna go next. We're not ready to go home. And actually she's like feeling better now. Like she's ready to rally. So we call the other Uber, and like, this is important later, but like we all are just like walking out, and like we wave to this guy that one of us had met actually weird at like Whole Foods earlier that day. And like my friend like knew his name, which was like they definitely like met there at the grocery store. Anyway, so we call the Uber, and it's taking like a really long time to get there. Like it's like 6 minutes away, but it's already, that's what it said, but it's already been like 13 minutes. And we're just like, it's a little bit cold out because it's, you know, it's the time of year where it's just like you don't want to bring your jacket because you'll forget it at the club, but you also like need it at the end of the night, you know, because it's just like a little chilly. So we are like waiting for this Uber, and then there's like this dog that was so cute. Like have you ever seen, it was the kind of dog, I've never seen one before this, but it was just like a mixture of a golden retriever and a Saint Bernard. And it was just like, it was so cute. And I was like, is this half golden? And she was like, yeah, it's actually up for adoption. I was like, don't tell me that, because I was like ready to adopt this dog. He was so adorable. Anyway, so Uber's coming, like it's 2 minutes away now. So we decide to like, you know, just like be ready for when it gets here so we can hop right in and just get on with our night, because the place was kind of toxic now. Like that's where the girl threw up, you know? But the weird thing is though, like as we were waiting, like it was like 2 minutes away, the Uber, we all just kind of at the exact same time, we all just kind of started to feel like a little weird. Just like not right. Not like we were gonna get sick, but just like, oh, something's different, you know? Like something's weird. It was this feeling like I never like felt in my life. I can't really explain it. It felt like I was gonna die. And I don't mean like I'm gonna die, like a joke. Like, I mean, I felt literally like if I got into this Uber, that's how I was going to pass away. Like I was going to die. And I wasn't the only one. Like I just look at my friends and we were all looking at each other and we're just like, suddenly we can all like read each other's thoughts. Like, are we dying? Like, are we dead already? It was just like, it was like a feeling I cannot even explain, but we were all on the exact same level. It was low-key sad. Honestly, like it was just like, this is it. This is the end. I've never felt before so much like a human being, like my humanness, my mortality. I've never felt quite that way. And I know my friends felt the exact same way. And it's because we all knew just like, for some reason, something wasn't right. So now the Uber is just like a minute away and it's about to pull up and we're just like, we can't get in this Uber, but we also just needed to get on with the night because, you know, we just need to get away from the club where the girl threw up. I wasn't gonna cancel the Uber and like not take the Uber. Like I called an Uber. You call an Uber, you like owe it to that driver who came all the way over. So I see it's like 1 minute away and it's just, it looks like it's like two blocks away, but it's really like one, you know, the apps just sometimes like skips a little bit. So I like see it coming around the corner. It's a super normal looking black car. I see the license plate's correct. Okay, so the Uber driver pulls up, like he's at the curb, like really slowly, just arrives. It says arrives, I like get the text on my phone, and he just like rolls down the window kind of slowly, and he just kind of like leans back a little bit in his seat, and I can't really make out his face, but he just like clears his throat and he's like, are you Julia? And at that moment I wasn't sure, but I answered yes, I'm Julia. And he said, how many people do you have? And it was me and my three friends. So I said, four. And I was still kind of feeling like I was dying, but like, it almost felt like he was ready to help me. I wasn't sure. So the Uber driver then, at this moment, he comes around. He opens the car door to the back seat. In that moment, I lift my foot to step into the car. My friends are all behind me. And the wind is just like blowing a little bit. And I'm like, just really like, I wish I had brought my coat at this point. I definitely would have remembered it that night. So like, this is the moment that like, it seriously changed my life. Like it seriously changed my life. So I just like take a deep breath. And I look at my friends, I look at them behind me, and they're just like, Julia, yeah, like this is what we gotta do. We gotta get in this Uber. So like one deep final breath, like I feel it just like glow through my body. And I step into that Uber.